if he will make a statement on what efforts the British government has made to fulfil the instruction of this House, dated the 27th of February 2019, which is to seek agreement on EU and British citizens' rights, and in particular the protection of British citizens in the EU in the event of no deal.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. May I start by paying tribute to my honourable friend, the Member for South Leicestershire, and his testament to his passionate defence of the rights of EU citizens and UK nationals that the amendment he brought before this House passed unanimously. That is a rare feat, and I congratulate him on the work that he's done on this. Additionally, I want to thank him for organising our recent meeting with representatives from the British in Europe and the 3 million to discuss their proposal to seek a joint UK-EU commitment to adopt Part 2 of the withdrawal agreement in any scenario. The Secretary of State was very grateful for the opportunity to hear their views and the views of my honourable friend on this matter. And as he will be aware, we have written to the EU's chief negotiator, Michel Barnier, to report their views, and in particular to make clear their views and those of the House that in a no-deal scenario, adopting the Citizens' Rights Agreement is far superior to 28 unilateral solutions. I've also had representations from the devolved nations of the UK indicating their support for this approach. Mike Russell, the Scottish Government's lead minister on EU exit, wrote to the Secretary of State recently to set out the Scottish Government's support for adopting the Citizens' Rights Agreement. This Government has been steadfast in its commitment to protect the rights of EU citizens. They are our friends, our colleagues and our neighbours, and we want them to stay. We are also already implementing our no-deal offer to EU citizens in the UK, and the EU settlement scheme opened successfully on the 30th of March. Over 750,000 EU citizens have now applied. The Secretary of State wrote to the EU to seek their views on adopting the citizens' rights part of the withdrawal agreement in any scenario, and Michel Barnier responded on the 25th of March. Last night, my Secretary of State issued a response to Michel Barnier, reporting recent conversations with my honourable friend for South Leicestershire, the 3 million and the British in Europe, and asked for our officials to be able to continue to work together to explore how best we protect the rights of citizens in all scenarios. In the response, the Secretary of State reaffirmed adopting the citizens' rights parts of the agreement as a UK-EU solution will offer the greatest protection for nationals in the EU and EU citizens in the UK. This is due to the importance of rights, such as the agreed social security coordination provisions, which cover areas such as reciprocal healthcare and the accumulation of pension contributions. These do require a reciprocal agreement in order to provide the best level of operation. The Secretary of State wrote to my honourable friend this morning, enclosing a copy of this letter, and it has been deposited in the Library of the House this morning and published on gov.uk. Finally, I'd like to reaffirm that citizens' rights has been a priority throughout the negotiations, and it is an area that both the Government and this House takes extremely seriously. As such, the best way to guarantee those rights, both for UK nationals in the EU and EU citizens in the UK, is for this House to approve a deal.